talk about today. Just, I suppose, previewing some of the commentary that we're likely to hear from BHP. Get to them in just a minute. Before we do, though, Rio, the other big miner out today, certainly stealing some of the thunder, if you like, from BHP. $5 billion in cost cutting over the next couple of years. Big target, Julia.
James, we've heard from Rio Tinto today, and this is at its investor seminar in Sydney, which is focusing in on iron ore. And the focus on cost cutting, really good news for some of these mining companies, but it's going to be another hit for that mining services sector, because we know that when we do see these big miners like BHP, Rio Tinto, cutting out to cut such significant costs, usually it's the contractors, those mining service companies, which are hit. So we are watching those mining service companies today. We have a look at what Rio Tinto has said today. It is still focused in on expanding its Pilbara operations to 290 million tonnes per annum. So that's on track, and that's on budget. They're currently producing at about 150,000 million tonnes per annum. So they're still looking at expanding their iron ore operations, but they are looking at cutting capital expenditure by $1 billion by the end of next year. So that's going to be a negative for those mining service companies. Also targeting $5 billion worth of cost savings, and that's by the end of 2014. Most of those cost savings are going to come from aluminium as well as from the coal division. And we've seen both of these commodity prices coming under pressure. But Rio Tinto is not the only one cutting costs. We've also heard from Grange Resources this morning. It's looking at cutting development costs and expenditure at its South Down magnetite project. So we'll be watching Grange Resources very closely. And of course, BHP's AGM. BHP's already gone on a huge cost-cutting program, delaying capital expenditure as well, so we'll be watching for any comments. So it could potentially be quite a big hit for those mining services companies today. Rio Tinto first off the bat, we've also heard from Grange Resources, and we've got BHP's AGM later today.
Jill, I thought it was interesting in the release by Rio Tinto talking about their future earnings, i.e., you know, where they're going to go to as we see the commodity cycle mature. And they're talking about benefiting, positioning themselves from mid to late cycle commodities such as titanium dioxide. I have to confess, I'm not exactly an expert when it comes to titanium dioxide. I'm not sure if you are, but talking about looking, I suppose, moving away from some of these early cycle commodities that have really seen them build up these balance sheets and positioning themselves as you'd hope to see as to where they're going to be in the future.
I guess if we have a look at titanium dioxide, it's really used in things like paints, in terms of pigments, as well as things like makeup as well. So it's a mineral that's used, and I guess it's driven really by the urbanization once again of China. But really, this is the key. China's a key driver of a lot of these commodities. So we're watching China very carefully. And the good news is that we have started to see some positive signs coming out of the Chinese economy. It does look like manufacturing has bottomed out in that third quarter, and we're watching that very closely. But the other thing to watch is the new political party in China. In the first quarter of the year, we're expecting to get a better idea of where this new party is headed in terms of stimulating the Chinese economy and in terms of its policies. One of the things that we've found in the last few weeks is potential tax cuts for domestic iron ore miners, coal miners in China. And of course, that could have a flow-on effect to make other iron ore miners outside of China perhaps a little bit less competitive. So it could be about giving some of those domestic producers a boost. So we are watching China as well as any policy changes very carefully. But the key, of course, is growth in China. And we have seen seven quarters of slowing growth in China. Now, Rio Tinto has come out to say that they do expect growth of more than 8% in China next year. But of course, this is a key driver of commodities, what China is going to do in terms of growth.
Rooms again, they don't change, they're all very bare. Be full in about an hour's time. Let's go back to Julia Lee, get her thoughts on BHP. I wanted to get your thoughts, Julia, on, we were talking before about Rio positioning itself for mid to late cycle sort of commodities, titanium dioxide. Your thoughts on BHP and shale? We just heard Ingrid there suggest that it's many people now seeing it as a boom. The timeline is a little bit fuzzy, but look, at the time, they were a little bit, took a bit of a stick to them, the market thing. They bought at the top of the cycle. Look, your thoughts on the differing strategies of the two miners?
I think the positive nature of shale gas really peaked a couple of years ago, and that's really why we've seen these write-downs for BHP coming through, because we have seen a huge drop in natural gas prices in the US. Now, there is some talk that shale gas could be exported out to China, but of course there's a shipping cost involved in that as well. So at the moment, this is a supply-demand story, and it does look like there's way too much supply in the US in terms of shale gas. And I think what investors are going to be watching out for is whether we're going to see more write-downs in this shale gas area. There's been a boom in this area. Prices have come down significantly. And the question is whether we are going to see some more write-downs to their shale gas assets. I think oil and energy really is going to be in focus because that's what really differentiates BHP Billiton from Rio Tinto, the oil and gas assets. And if we have a look at oil prices at the moment, there is some concern that demand will soften off. So I guess some concern around those oil and gas assets, and I guess there'll be a lot of question marks around that. And also BHP has deferred some huge projects. So capital expenditure, whether costs are rising, will be very much in focus. No doubt those mining services companies will be listening in very carefully. And then the succession planning as well. If we have a look at where BHP might invest for the future, I guess getting away from some of those bulk commodities as well as energy type commodities. And if we have a look at things like potash, fertilizer is a key area of growth. It's seen as a big area of growth because of the demand for food and the urbanization of China and China moving towards a larger middle class. So fertilizer is seen as a big area of growth over the next few decades, and BHP has tried to expand into this area a couple of times before. So it's going to be interesting to keep an eye out for any potential acquisitions or plans for acquisitions coming through from BHP. No doubt that this is going to be a big one for our market, given that it's the biggest stock on the Aussie share market.